Are the organization policies maintained even when the leadership change?
No, the Arab League position don't change if the leadership change, because the Arab League policies are based on the decisions and resolution of the Council of Ministers of the Arab League and the bodies associated with the Arab Leagues. So there is, it is an institutional policies based on decision by the leaders of the Arab world when they meet in the Council of the Arab League. There is no rush, there is no abrupt change of policy. The policies are well thought, and the Arab League leadership execute and formulate the policies in association with the interest of the Arab world and the decision made by the head of state of the Arab countries.
How is the current relationship between the press and the Arab League?
The Arab League, and particularly Secretary General Msi Omar Moussa, have an open policy toward the press and very good relations. The Information Department of the Arab League and the Secretary General himself are very open to press organizations, and every day we are in contact with the press in the headquarters of the Arab League in Cairo and in all offices of the Arab League all over the world. We try, it is in our interest, and it is the policy of the Arab League to be open and very straightforward in communicating informations concerning the Arab world in general, concerning the work of the Arab League to the press. And we, the Secretary General, give interview all over the world, and the department office concerned with the informations also give a press release daily concerning all activities of the Arab Leagues and all event in the world. There are comment and interviews given by the Arab League officials. Here in Buenos Aires also, we are very open to the press. We have good relation with the press. We meet with press people daily. We try to give them all information we can give about the work of the Arab League and the resolutions and the activities of the Arab League. We are convinced that the press is very important in, first of all, disseminating information, but also in making people understand the position of the Arab world and the position of the Arab League, because we are convinced that we are a peace seeker. We want peace. We want our position to be understood like they are, based on fairness, understanding, and for the good of the regions.
How is the position of Aralib with respect to nuclear energy?
The Arab League position on nuclear energy is very clear, very simple. We think that it's the right of every country to have nuclear energy, the peaceful use of nuclear energy. And many countries in the region are trying to have nuclear energy facilities for producing electricity and the use in medicine and other matters, peaceful use of nuclear energy. But concerning the military use of nuclear energy, we don't think it's a good idea for the region. We have called for a Middle East free zone from nuclear military powers. But unfortunately, this has not been the case, because Israel is having military nuclear warhead, and it's not part of the international agreements, and it refused to accept a Middle East free zone from military. We are working. We worked in Vienna lately. We worked in the United Nations. Every time there is a possibility, we try to push with the idea of Middle East military free zone from nuclear warhead. That's the position of the Arab League. Two aspects. Use possibility of the utilization of the nuclear energy for peaceful means, but also the Middle East free from nuclear military utilization of nuclear power.